Let's face it, electricity is freaking cool, but it's not cool like these two. Denki Kaminari, the stun gun hero charge bolt from My Hero Academia. And Pichu, the baby forward version of Pikachu from Pokemon. I'm Jen, I'm with Sonic.
I'm Jeff.
Can you quit with your dramatic gestures? It's getting annoying.
No, never.
Well, I can't stop you. And it's our job to analyze their stats, weapons, and abilities to find out who will determine their legendary mission. Well, there's not really that much of a backstory for Kaminari, but did you notice that his name, Denki Kaminari, actually means electrical thunder in Japanese?
Really? I always thought that meant a compliment.
Oh, well, not really. It's not really a compliment, but let's just go to this. Now, there's not really much of an official backstory, but we do know that he's actually a friendly guy.
All that to say, we are all being very quiet since our parents are asleep.
Well, yes, we're both roommates, but let's just get on to this. But still, Denki Kaminari is actually one of the best students in UA High School. Well, that's in my opinion, actually. But still, he is actually a friendly... He's actually a friendly friend to Kirishima, Bakugo, and even his soon-to-be wife, Jiro.
Wait, he's going to have a wife?
Well, Jiro and Kaminari do share a similar relationship, so... Probably.
Okay, you're weird.
Sorry, it's just something going on in my mind. But still, Denki Kaminari is actually pretty capable of fighting and possibly is very smart. Well, he struggles at tests, but he doesn't struggle in real life talking to his opponents more smartly. He doesn't show to have intelligence at school, but he does show to have intelligence in combat.
Really? How so?
Have you seen the manga and the anime?
Oh, okay, I get it.
Still, now let's go on to his powers and abilities. Now, if you don't notice, that Kaminari's quirk is actually electrification, which makes him shock his opponents way beyond. But however, he does have a weakness to this, since he can't fry his brain and turn him into a huge idiot. But let's just get onto his abilities before we go onto his weaknesses, which we did cover right now. Now, he usually doesn't do that much, since he can shoot a bolt of electricity from thin air or on the ground. And plus, he can actually use his electricity to travel on the ground and makes enemies shock on their feet.
You could say they have a shocking to their feet.
Really, Jeff? Puns are my thing.
Okay.
Let's just get on to this. Okay. Well, this does have an electrical problem to this.
Really?
Whatever, Jeff. But anyways, this does have an electrical justification to this, since he can use it way beyond. But before we go on to his two super weapons, let's go on to his basic weapons. Now, he can shoot electricity, and he can increase his electricity and power to make him more severely stronger.
And also, his two special moves, where he uses his special move at 1.3 million% of his power, making him a total powerhouse. But however, this does put a fair flaw since it can melt his brain and turn him into a complete idiot like we saw.
But Jeff said. And also, he doesn't usually uses his power at 1.3 million percent. He can go way beyond 2 million percent. With it, he is an absolute beast. It's hard to catch him. It's hard to even hit him. It is definitely hard to survive his electricity and can probably stop your heart, paralyze your muscles, and totally melt your bones. But however, this does drain his brain faster, making him a total complete idiot for 1 hour.
And also, he is significantly capable and strong too.
Yeah, he's kept up with Katsuki Bakugo, who once made an explosion worth about over 33 tons of TNT.
He's also fast too, fast as lightning. A burst of lightning travels a third of the speed of light. Jay, would you want to say it?
Yeah, like we said in the previous episode, a bolt of lightning travels a third of the speed of light, which is 220 million miles per hour, making him the third of the speed of light.
But like we said, Denki isn't perfect. Like we said, he is, his I stutter. What we do know this is that he froze his brain using too much power. But he isn't smart sailing in school, but also smart sailing in combat. But that does have a better advantage for Kaminari, right?
Well, yes. Kaminari is an absolute genius in combat. Like Isuka Midoriya, he can strategize and usually predict their opponents in combat, making him at least equal in intelligence to Deku. And no matter what, even though he's not perfect, he still remains the stun gun hero Charge Bolt we all love and know.
Pichu is Pikachu. Yes, that's his backstory. That's pretty much it. Yep, that's Jay.
Okay, well, before he became Pikachu, let's just go through this, shall we? Pikachu was a mouse all alone, with no family and no friends. But he usually made friends with some huge dude and some small dudes. But however, he did actually level up into the legendary Pikachu, leaving him to Ash Ketchum, which they became best friends and mainly fought Pokemons and tried to catch them to be the best in the world, etc. Blah blah blah. But let's just go to Pichu. Well, as we see Pichu in combat, he is actually cute, but he is a total beast. Well, let's just say he's not really that much of a cute like Kirby. He's cute but deadly. Well, he's not that kind of deadly, but he is significantly powerful. So you do not want to mess with this mouse, since he is pretty capable in combat. But let's just go through his abilities.
Yes, his first abilities is Thunder Jolt, which he shoots a bolt of electricity. Now where have I seen that before?
You say that from Pikachu.
Of course, they're the same person.
Well, except he's Pikachu.
I know that, but you know what, never mind, let's just get to this. But let's just go through his abilities still. Well, he can shoot a bolt of electricity from thin air, but which moves at around 98,000 meters per second.
Which is significantly fast. Which is a Mach 258.2, I guess. I don't know, it's actually kind of hard to explain. But yeah, he can charge himself and hit enemies with his head.
And that would be the Skull Bash.
You seem to know a lot about Pokemon.
Why wouldn't I? It's the best!
But what about his super move?
Oh, that would be... what was that name? Oh, no, give me a minute.
Really, Jeff? You have to do this now?
I got it.
Well, Pichu's super move is actually capable of destroying enemies at an instant state, which he travels at around the third of the speed of light, which we stated was around 220 million miles per hour.
Thunder Tackle! Was that it?
I guess you spent the whole time thinking about it while I just explained it.
Already? Aw, man. Let's go through his weakness.
Oh yeah, his weakness is well known. He does significantly damage himself during himself in an injured state, and would make himself a fatal flaw. While, however, he does have impressive strength and speed and durability, he does actually damage himself after this.
But still, no matter what, Pichu will still remain cuter than Pikachu.
Bless you.
I didn't sneeze. I just said Pikachu.
Bless you.
Oh my god. That's not funny, Jay.
Of course it is funny.
You know what? Let's just move on. It's unbelievable.
You're just mad because I make better puns.
Shut up.
Alright, catch your votes in, people, because it's time to see who will determine the legendary mission. Let's settle this! I got that line from a friend.
Yeah.
Wow, I literally did not see the violent part coming.
Wait, what? I thought the teacher easily wins this one. What happened?
Okay, now hold on. Let's get to the point here. Now, both Kaminari and Pichu both share similar abilities when it comes to shooting people with electricity and lightning. And plus, Pichu had better experience in training, so he had both combatants, Kaminari and Pichu, had experience training, so they both shared equal equally matched with each other. But if it hasn't to be fair, Kaminari has insanely greater aspects.
Really? How so?
Okay, now both Kaminari and Pichu share similar reaction speed. Well, for a little bit.
What do you mean? Both of these guys can react to freaking lightning.
Yeah, but believe it or not, that's still technically slower than Kaminari.
Really? How so?
Okay, let's see. See, Kaminari travels a third of the speed of light, which travels at about 220 million miles per hour, but Pichu is actually significantly slower than that. Given to how he's reacting to, like, a slower arrow going down, that's like the kind of lightning that he reacts to. So given to how he's moving at that slower lightning kind of rate, which moves at about 98,000 meters per second, or 219,219.757 miles per hour. That's 103 times slower than Kaminari.
Okay, so that's speed. But what about strength?
Well, strength... that would actually go to Kaminari, but we'll get to that in a minute. Then let's discuss durability. Now, durability, I would have to get this to beat you. Now, Kaminari did actually take hits from giant people beyond his size. But Pichu has survived the monster hits and freaking Mewtwo. Well, give or take that he was in his Pikachu state, but that still counts as a Pichu state too. Now, let's go on to the question that everyone would like to hear. Who uses their power more carefully?
That would obviously go to Pichu.
Well, not exactly. Let's check out how they use their powers. Now, Kaminari, as we stated, that he turns into a complete idiot while he uses too much of his power. But Pichu takes too much damage while using at 4% of his power. So, I would state that Kaminari uses his powers more safely. Like, it's actually kind of better to turn yourself into an idiot rather than damaging your whole body at once.
Okay, as much as I hate to admit it, Kaminari does stand a better chance.
And that would be a strength point, and that would possibly go to Kaminari because striking strength, Kaminari takes it. Lifting strength, Kaminari takes it too. Because Kaminari doesn't even need to use all of his full power. But if he would want to, then he would want to because he would have no other chance but to do it. And see, Pichu has to go, far beyond his powers in order to hurt Kaminari because Kaminari is actually pretty durable. I know that he doesn't have an impressive durability state, but however, we can scale him to similar characters that we know to be at lesser level. In this case, Shoto Todoroki, Katsuki Bakugo, Ichiro Kirishima, and Izuku Midoriya. Both of these guys had shown impressive durability feats, with Kirishima turning himself into hard as a rock, Katsuki Bakugo setting off explosions where Todoroki and Izuku Midoriya can survive, and plus, Izuku Midoriya and Katsuki Bakugo took hits from All Might. Remember that?
Well, yes, okay. As much as I hate to admit it, Kaminari did handle durability more. While scaling...
But still, I'm sorry, it's the way it has to be. So, all Kaminari can do is just hurt him while not even using his full power. Pichu, on the other hand, has to use every single part of his power in order to hurt Kaminari. He had to use, its thunder tackle just in order to hurt Kaminari more painfully. But Kaminari, though, couldn't even just use, 2,000,000% of his power. I mean, I know he can go way beyond that, but... Literally, he doesn't even really have to. I mean, yeah, it's really weird, but it is what it is. Now, both of these guys show durability. They both share speed. But however, Kaminari was faster, stronger, and more durable, and you could say way more smarter. Kaminari sure stunned his gun at Pichu.
Really? I was going to use that pun.
Yeah, I know. It was good, but I Pichu to it.
Oh my god, you know what? I quit.
Wow, what a sore loser. The winner is the Stun Gun Hero Charge Bolt, aka Danky Kaminari.